Welcome to this episode of Toot Tunes Podcast. My mic sounds far away. Was it off?
It was not off, but it was not going on through your headphones.
Oh, that's weird. Why? It sounds better than last time, though.
Yes, it does. 100%. That, you know,
what a difference a week makes.
It's been a week, so that a Church Girls episode.
Man, it was great. It's too exciting to talk about right now.
Yeah, just go listen to it.
Yeah, we dropped a bonus episode.
And I mean, if you waited this long, like, you missed it, because it's like the biggest song in the world right now.
So, Bo, what is it you'd say we do here?
We talk about two tunes.
Okay.
I was going to make some stupid joke, but
it's not really working. We've been doing this for a while, right? How many episodes?
I think it's 35 plus 34, that many episodes.
34, 35, maybe. I don't know. How many, but which episode number is it?
69.
Nice.
you just wanted that. Yeah. Here, this is what...
And neither of us picked... That's 69 beats per minute. Great. Neither of us picked songs to be, you know, like around that, because that would be ridiculous.
You did. I didn't.
What? I don't think so. I just was like, I gotta play my girl.
Like, I love Ariana.
I do like. I like this album.
Yeah,
I like this song too.
Yeah, the song's weird to me.
That was pretty nice. Anyway,
because so I still think of Ariana Grande as a child.
So yeah, see, I never like watched Disney
Neither
Channel
did I.
Past
but it's
that
like
time.
Still, it's like, yeah. Like when she was on Sam and Cat. I've seen a couple episodes of that because I don't know why. It's okay. Like my son was watching it when he was really, really little, sure. Or it was just on TV. I don't know. I have no idea why I watched that show. Yeah. Just like, hey guys. Was she Sam or was she Cat? I don't even know.
No idea.
I don't know.
But that was a spinoff of something else, right?
It was a spinoff of two shows.
Oh.
There were two shows, so Victorious and like maybe iCarly.
Okay.
And then like there were characters on those shows. Uh-huh. There was... So I watched this YouTube channel. I don't watch it, but I watched this one video, and it's like kind of like a quick discography of like anybody who's like had like more than like five releases. Okay. And it's like, hey, here's the first release, and here are like nine songs, and like they did this, and like this is like super quick reviews of these albums.
Okay.
There was one about Ariana Grande and like what everything is, but like, then the person was like talking about how Sam and Cat did this, and it's like, and then blah blah blah, and then there's this character and her name was Kat, and then like the blah blah blah, and then this person was named Sam, and then they put them together, and they missed the opportunity to call it Kat and Sam. Instead it was Sam and Kat, which was really dumb. It was a stupid joke, but it stuck in my head.
Yeah So my first.
Yeah, your first.
All right, so this is 34 plus 35, or 34.
Does she
35?
Ever actually say 34 plus?
No, she always 35? Says 34, 35.
34, 35.
Yeah.
Or something like that. I don't know.
It is the second track off of her 2020 release, Positions.
What's the cover to this one?
Her face and doing the hand holding.
You know, I should know because it's right there.
Holding thing, yeah.
It's not the like the bunny ears thing.
No.
That was the one before it.
That maybe?
Yeah.
Anyways, Next was the album.
Remember, kids, this is your childhood. Cover. Oh, then it's even two more before that.
Maybe.
Said her first, like, I'm an adult now.
Maybe. Dangerous Woman, 2016. Might have been that first one.
Yeah. Is this a banger to continue from last week?
I would say so.
Okay.
Are there bigger bangers on this album?
Obviously. Probably. Because this one is just weird to me. And inappropriate for the kids.
I like this album.
Okay.
It's catchy. It's good. I'm a sucker for good, catchy pop songs. And,
okay.
Yeah. This one's funny, obviously.
This is Two Tunes Podcast, by the way, and we talk about Two Tunes. I'm Bo.
We said that.
I don't know.
I'm Brandon.
You just really wanted to dive into the number.
No, we got something else to do, so that's why I was just trying to get
Oh, yeah. We have a...
We have a thing to do in the past.
We have a thing to do that you already heard. Yeah.
Anyway, no, but the where is it going with this? Oh, so last week we talked about lyric writing.
Yeah,
this I'll talk a little bit about the lyrics. It's funny because it's suggestive, but then other times it's just overt.
Yeah,
because I think the first time I heard it, I was like, oh, this is like, it's kind of clever. Like some of the, like, you're talking around using a little double entendres and little,
yeah, until it gets to the chorus.
And then sometimes it's just like straight up, like, nope, we're gonna bang, like.
Yeah,
cool. Shall we play?
We should start
the song.
You might think I'm crazy, the way I've been craving. What's she craving?
I don't know, Bo. If I put it quite plainly, just give me them babies. I like that line. If I put it quite plainly, just give me them babies. Just get me pregnant, I guess.
Yeah.
Although, yeah. If she does the thing that the song title's about, that's not going to...
That doesn't work, kids.
So what you doing tonight? Better stay doing you right. Yeah. Watching movies, but we ain't seen a thing tonight. Yeah. I don't wanna keep you up, you. But show me, can you keep it up? Yeah. Cause then I'll have to keep you up. So maybe I'ma keep you up.
This is how you make me uncomfortable, by the way. Like, yeah. So there was an artist that Fresh Finn suggested we listen to, and it's this level for the whole EP.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I would just never. So songs that I would never bring are songs about sex.
Okay.
I don't know why. I mean, it just makes me
uncomfortable. Because of your puritanical
upbringing. Because I'm a Puritan. Yeah. I'm a Puritan. I'm reading the lyrics.
I know you are.
Right? I know this line.
Yeah. It's funny that they put the plus sign in the lyrics.
I think
thing.
It's hard to read. Like it's hard. You know, I'm not going to stop it. We can just talk over top of fine. It. I think it's hard to say it. 34, 30. Like. Like something is cut a little bit. Like she's not really saying 34, 35.
Right.
She's like 34. Like yeah. I don't.
She. I forget if I haven't listened to her a ton. I think that's kind of her delivery style of like not totally
like slurring things. Not slurring.
Almost like a Patrick Stump from Fall Out Boy. Like he doesn't. He on purpose does not enunciate super well. He's said that before.
So there's this meme
this
that's
is
going
funny for me to watch Bo squirm.
Yeah, it really is, isn't it?
This would be a good one for a video episode.
Yeah, this would be. There's this video, and it's like this really hit me when Eddie Vedder said whatever, and then it's like,
oh,
it's not words.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's just like, yeah, and it's like I don't really know what he's saying at all. Like, it doesn't make sense. I can't hear.
Can you pause for a second?
Yeah, because you really want to.
Did you see that on TikTok?
Yeah.
And it was, like, some, like,
Mitchell
Norwegian
from...
town.
Yeah, I don't know.
And it's, like, 58 letters long, but it's, like, all one word.
Yeah.
It's that. At least that's the version of it that I saw.
Okay. But even, wait, like what he's saying sounds like what's written, but those aren't words.
Right.
And then it's, like. When Eddie Vedder said this, it really hit me. And I'm like, I don't like I know that song and I really don't know what the words are. And it's not like it's muffled at all.
Yeah.
It's like he's just not really saying the words.
There's one of my favorite
podcasts.
I'm gonna
keep going with this so we can get over it with sooner.
No, it's a good song. Okay. Can you appreciate the song though?
Oh yeah, it's a good song. But I'm just like, well, excuse me.
Just the subject matter. Yeah.
Yeah. Don't need no side dick.
Wait, what is it?
Yeah. It's 100% about sex, if you didn't know.
I don't know. I feel like if it is, she'll mention it right at the end, just in case you weren't sure what she meant. That's actually the funniest part of the song to me.
Like this? Like?
No. You'll hear it.
Well, yeah, I know what you're talking about. Yeah, math class never was good.
Wait for it, here it comes.
This is your favorite part.
Wait.
Yeah.
Math class, it's like right at the end. I think the first time I heard that song, I like laughed out loud because it was so funny. It was like, you just made this very explicit song. And then at the very end, you're like, just in case you didn't quite catch the last 2.5 minutes.
Yeah.
This is what I mean.
Yeah. No shit. Math class never was good.
Yeah. Oh, I started to say, so there's one of my favorite podcasts is called Puck Soup. Mm-hmm. I hate their theme song, by the way. So no theme songs for us here. So that way people don't get sick of it. But he's got this line in it. I've been listening to this podcast for like 5 or 6 years now, however long it's been going. And he's got this line in it that mm-hmm. I had to look up the lyrics at one point, and then I forgot what the lyric was. And I still every now and then forget what it is. And mm-hmm. even though I've looked it up and thought about it and I can hear what he's saying, kind of, I still don't actually know what he's saying. And it's very strange to me.
Mm-hmm.
And it has something to do. The line is also kind of weird. So it's, if I remember it, it's like, we also cover, so it's a hockey podcast, but he says we also cover like movies, TV shows, to what if your commute. So okay. like to make you think like, I think that's what it like to what if your commute. So like you're listening to it on your commute, but mm-hmm. it's going to make you like, what if, but I'm like, it doesn't, you wouldn't what if your commute, like that doesn't make sense.
Okay.
So that's, but anyway, every now and then I forget what that lyric is and I have to listen. I'm like, wait, what did he say? Like, I don't get it. But anyway, that made me think of that.
What you just made me think of is there's
your favorite
a joke.
Ariana Grande song.
Yeah. Yeah. It's this one.
I also like Positions. Hair is a good one. You should listen to that one, Bo.
Wait, is this... This is off Positions.
Mm-hmm.
Is all the songs Positions?
No.
It'd be hilarious if it was.
No, Hair is one. Yeah. Shut Up.
Shut Up.
Motive with Doja Cat. Just okay. Like Magic. Off the Table with The Weeknd. 6:30. Safety Net featuring Ty Dolla $ign.
So there's a...
Nasty.
Yeah.
West Side. Love Language.
There was this comedian Obvious. On TikTok.
POV. That's it.
Are you sure? You want to keep going? It's not 20 tracks. Did you look up the extended edition, the special edition that came out two Ooh, months later?
I should.
Don't do that. So, like, there's this comedian on TikTok that was mm-hmm. talking about how Chuck Lorre, the guy who created the Big Bang Theory.
Oh, there's a remix. We should listen to the remix.
Of what?
Of 3435.
No.
Doja Cat, Megan Thee Stallion.
Oh, totally makes sense.
We should listen to it.
I can't get it.
Sure you can.
It did take a while.
Sure.
So he was talking about how Chuck Lorre, mm-hmm. creator of Big Bang Theory, he yes. wrote the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle theme song from
I
the
saw
90s.
This. Yeah.
And he got paid like $300
right.
for writing it, right? And then he created the show, Big Bang Theory, but then had another artist create the theme song for that.
The Bare Naked Ladies.
Bare Naked Ladies. They got paid $1 million. Then they spent it all on like John... What's the guy's name? The Elephant Man.
Oh, okay.
John Merrick.
Yeah.
Merrick's remains.
Okay.
It's like they had a list or something.
What?
All those elephant bones. You're not a big Bare Naked Ladies fan.
No.
All those big Bare Naked Ladies fan are laugh. Actually, they're probably like, "That's really dumb, dude." Like Christian knows the song. So Bare Naked Ladies had a song
yeah.
called $1 million. And it was about if they
I
bought
had $1 million.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
And that's the joke because they got paid $1 million.
Okay.
And then it's like all those elephant bones. I don't know.
Okay. Cool.
They'd buy a treehouse.
That's right. It's slowly
with a fridge. And Velveeta Mac. I don't know. I forget what it is.
I'm asleep now.
I that reminds me of a summer camp. That song because I think I went to a summer camp for like a week
okay.
which was like 20 minutes from my house.
My only Bare Naked Ladies anecdote is
I saw them
in the early days
with Hootie and the Blowfish,
everybody having the internet like when I was in high school.
Yeah.
And 1 week was out.
It's been
and somebody got me a copy of the lyrics that they had like found online.
Yeah.
And I remember China. Like treasuring that. I was like, oh my gosh, I have the lyrics to this song and I don't even have the CD. And I just thought that was like mind blowing. Pretty sure they lived like folded up in my like Barry Sachs case for like 2 years.
Welcome to the internet.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw them in Hershey.
Yeah.
For free.
Pretty good.
Oh, they were
like,
great.
Recently.
Right before the pandemic.
Oh, okay.
It was them, Bare Naked Ladies, or it was Bare Naked Ladies and Hootie and the Blowfish. And I think yeah. it was just those two. I think okay. there was only two bands.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hootie was really good.
Yeah.
Their backdrop was like amazing. It okay. looked like they were actually in a place.
Huh.
And then it like it was a video screen and then they changed it. And it's like, oh, you look like you're now somewhere else.
Yeah, that's cool.
It was kind of like how they filmed The Mandalorian.
Oh, in The Volume.
In The Volume.
Yeah.
Is it called The Volume?
It's called The Volume.
It's called The Volume.
Yeah.
All right. I know nothing about Kill Birds. Okay. Kills Birds.
Kills Birds.
What I do know is that grungy, a bit.
Okay.
Sounds a little bit grungy. Uh-huh. Was recorded at Dave Grohl's studio.
Okay.
Studio 606 in LA, which is like the Neve. So that collab episode that we did, Dave Grohl, Josh Homme, and Trent Reznor, that song was recorded there and through that console, that's legendary console that Tom Petty and a whole bunch of other people. Well, now Kills Birds has also been through that. I discovered this band through JHS Pedals. So JHS Pedals will do like Record Time. Like at the end of like their episodes, they'll be like, Record Time. Here's a record. It's cool because of this. Go listen to it. Mm-hmm. Kind of like what we're doing.
Yeah.
Except they're also doing a whole bunch of other stuff.
Right.
Record Time is like 2 seconds. And then if you're like, oh, that looks cool, then you pick it up. If not, whatever. I'm here for the pedals. So Kill Birds. Kills Birds. First off, the name is hard to say. And it sounds cool. This song's called Rabbit. It's the first track off this record, which the record's good too. Like the whole thing, it's great. Yeah. And I like this because of the, you know, I'll just start it. We can talk about it. Be quick.
This is how I talk about you. I never raise my hand for a second.
Like it's 1990s, right?
Wish the vocals are more forward.
Okay.
It's just me.
All right.
But I like it.
Like I can still hear the
but
vocals.
But it fits the aesthetic.
Yes. That part, because you're just like, wait, what happened? And then like that dynamic of like super quiet, and then really loud. I love that, because nobody does that anymore, and not like to that extent.
I'm reading the lyrics as it goes by.
Exactly like the other girls. And like the first how is like a breath in.
Off. Yeah.
Could I let you? There's emotion in it, which I think is great. Like you have to. There's people who sing songs with like no, like I'm just singing the notes. I'm getting the notes, and the notes are perfect. But like there's no emotion. It's just like, do you even know what this song's about?
I think this song's about assault.
That I don't know.
It kind of feels like it. Like, it just feels like there's definitely something kind of sinister.
Maybe. Possibly.
Like, how could I let you? How could I? You know what I mean?
Yeah. It could be.
Or even just about like a... At the very minimum, I think it's just about like a really crappy relationship.
Mm-hmm.
But... Could be. I don't know. But it's a good song. It's quick. It's... How long is it? Do you have the time stamp here?
1:48.
Yeah. But just like gets the point across.
Yeah. This is a real short episode because your song was short and mine song was short. Tur.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. We had a question of like, what wouldn't we put on the podcast? Like what songs? And I mean, I kind of talked about it a little bit.
Bo had his choice. It wouldn't be 34-35.
Yeah. But like besides that, like songs that you wouldn't put on the podcast.
Oh, I think we said it's mostly about length of song.
Yeah. So like, I no, you know what? I don't want to say
that.
Because
I've got a piece that's 15 minutes,
but
that I love.
Like I think I could put The Decline by NOFX on this, which is an 18-minute song.
Right.
But there's enough change in it.
Yeah.
That's like there's something that you can kind of like talk about every minute.
I get that.
Of that 15 minutes. Yeah. I think that song could work. So I don't think it's like length, it's variety. Like if there's not a lot of variety to it.
So if it's like 10 minutes, but it's like just like a slow
yeah.
thing.
And yeah. it's like, this song is so great. You need to listen to it. But it's like 10 minutes of just build mm-hmm. to like nothing.
Yeah.
And it's like, it's
yeah,
so
because that piece that I have that's like 15 minutes, it's technically in three parts, but it's all one mm-hmm. thing. But even within each of those three parts, there's stuff
yeah.
changes and happens and builds and does. So I could do that.
I really think it's like things we wouldn't bring that we love. And we should probably just like add that in, like that 15 minute song. Like, we're not going to have it on the podcast, but what is it? Tell people.
So what if I want to put it on the podcast?
Do you? But maybe. You just said you wouldn't.
But I might not. But now you've got me thinking that maybe I would.
Yeah. I just think like, so songs that I wouldn't that, like I don't think anything on my mind that like I wouldn't put that on the podcast, but like things that I can't talk about. Like if we're just going to like, well, we're just going to listen to it. Be like, oh, I like that part.
Uh-huh.
And then silence for another like 3 minutes.
And we've
like,
done that though on like 3 minute songs. Too, we sometimes. Have. There's just sometimes we just don't have as much to talk about, or sometimes it's just like, yeah. this is just too good. I can't.
Yeah.
I don't want to talk over it.
Like hip hop songs, we don't really feature that much because it's like you don't want to talk over the lyrics because that's yeah. the important thing.
Right.
Or at least for me, that is. But I think it's like, yeah, longer songs, we don't want to like, yeah. even though we could have totally done that, we're only at like 21 minutes here. Yeah.
I think you had, it's funny because you, when I played that BTS song a few weeks ago,
mm-hmm.
I think I kind of got a sense that you were like, why are we putting like the biggest band in the world on? Like it should be about like
yeah.
But at the same time, you've played like Nine Inch Nails and you want to do Nirvana and you want to. So yeah. like, I'm not saying it's a right or wrong approach. I think at some point I had the thought of, I really want to use this platform to like feature all these
smaller
people that people may not know.
Yeah.
But at the same time, because I even had that with like, so I do these like weekly listening assignments with my theory class, which is all kinds of music. Mostly to just expose them to different things.
Mm-hmm.
But I will occasionally play people that they know or artists that they know, but maybe in a different context or mm-hmm. like a song. There's no way you heard this song. It's a B-side on this EP they released at one point. You know what I mean? Like that mm-hmm. kind of stuff. Now, sorry, 3435 and Butter by BTS is not that. It's just, it's just a good song that I like.
You're
so that's also the point of the podcast is to feature stuff we like. No, not at all. Not really. You know what I mean? Like,
do you ever think about that? I was just like, well, you don't even look at the numbers at all. Like,
I have no clue that unless you tell me, you're like, we got 34 downloads today. And I was like, I don't know if that's good. I think we have 6 listeners, so it sounds good.
Yeah.
But I don't know that there's anything I wouldn't bring in other than, like I said, depending on length of song. And that also has to do with, like we said, like the content. So I don't know. There's a recording of a Duke Ellington piece I really like called Single Petal of a Rose. It's like a specific version of it. It's probably like 7.5-8 minutes long. It's gorgeous. I wouldn't want to say a single word over it though. I would want to like talk about it beforehand, talk about it afterhand, and then just let it play.
Afterhand?
I said that, but I was like, that's got to be a thing, right? But do you know what I mean? Like, it's that type of thing. It's just, I want people to sit and listen to that piece in their headphones in the silence in a dark room, you know, and just experience it. And like, maybe I can give you some info about it before you listen, or we can discuss it after we listen. But that's one that I wouldn't want to talk over at all.
I got you.
So you're pulling up the analytics right now.
Yeah. And I mainly just go like over the past week. And I look at for like the most recent episode and like, did it reach where I think everything is?
Mm-hmm.
So like, 2 weeks ago, that's at 17 downloads or whatever.
What's episode was that?
Fruit Bats.
Okay.
The one that Christian really loves.
So Christian deleted his,
you know, a download's a download. If you download it once and you delete it, you download it again. It's like, thanks for the money. We don't get any money for this. No. But and also like see like,
so how did BTS do in comparison to everything else?
Like
any different at all
in the whole thing?
Yeah, was there any difference?
Okay, so BTS in the first day got 17 or 19 downloads, which is not like the highest, but it's up there.
Okay,
then it went up to 26 within the week, and then after 30 days, it's been like it's got to 30.
Okay.
now.
Is that average?
Depends. Like Scary Pockets has kind of been like our most recent really good episode.
Okay.
Where it's at 55 in the month, within the yeah. month.
See, I wonder, like, how do people...
I think they go down through and, like, hashtags on Instagram.
Yeah, I've started doing more of those.
Yeah.
To be more appealing and grab more people.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I don't know. It's just interesting. But anyway, I think it's okay for us to play big time people.
Yeah.
You know?
Uh-huh.
I don't know. Can be their biggest song, not biggest, like, it's whatever. It's just kind of what we're feeling. I had a big list, like, when we first started this.
Yeah.
Because it was like, oh, I want to feature this. And that we featured pretty much everything that I've wanted to.
Yeah.
In that time. So now it's like, I almost feel like, in a way, I struggle to find something. Not because I'm not into something, but because, like, I find stuff more recently or whatever. Now, those ones I found, like, via TikTok or something, like, those, I can just, boom, you know, yeah, I'm straight in. But just kind of going through, like, my liked songs on Spotify or whatever, liked albums. Like, oh, what's something I want to talk about?
Yep.
I don't know. We also did more research back in the day.
Yeah. I also look at this. No one can see what this is, but it's a graph.
Okay. And episode, like, performance.
Episode performance. But this is by quarters. So, okay. Like, you know, as long as we're kind of gaining, yeah. And this is, you know, this is April through June, and we're only April 14th. Uh-huh. So 14 days in, obviously it's not going to be as big as
right.
that is. But if we keep seeing this line go up, hey guys, welcome to analytics.
Did you have other questions you wanted to answer? From the people?
No. I mean, we'll just do one.
Okay.
What would we have? Long songs.
We'll have to, should we do a long song episode? Could be a theme, right?
Once a year, a long song.
Okay.
I already got the first one.
Fair enough. Me too.
The Decline.
Okay. Mine's called The Only Tune.
The what?
Only Tune.
The Only Tune?
Yeah.
All right. All right, guys, we will see you next week. But if you want to discuss or give us some information or just, you know, hang out, yep. There's a Discord.
Join the Discord.
Which the description in the there's a link in the description of this podcast. So if you just, like, scroll down.
Yeah. If you don't know how Discord works, there's, like, an invite link.
Yeah.
You have to use. You can't just, like, search it and find it.
So there's that. More people coming in that are more vocal. So yeah. People talking.
Yeah. Reach out to us on Instagram. Facebook, whatever, send us an email.
Two Tunes Podcast.
It helps if you, like, share stuff and tag us. That's super helpful. It just helps more people see it. And
if you like what you listen to, yeah. Like, subscribe, rate it on iTunes, mm-hmm. 5-star preferably.
If you're gonna go to the effort of doing a review, you might as well just
yeah.
Click the 5. It's as easy as clicking 1-star,
and then
because you just click all the way over,
you can share it on anything. Mm-hmm. Tell your friends.
Yeah.
Tell your loved ones. Tell your grandparents.
Tell your friends. Tell your enemies.
I feel like you hate this podcast and you shouldn't listen to it. It's too cool for you.
Yeah. You wouldn't even get it.
You're so dumb. Anyways, we'll talk to you next week with two new tunes.
Cool. Have a nice one.
Bye.
Bye.